Yeah, I guess that's the big question. Do you think that the Mandalorian will lose credibility without Baby Yoda? Do you think people will stop watching? Certain people will stop watching because there's no Baby Yoda.
I shouldn't do it.
All right, before we get started into this, I just have one question.
Ask
one
it.
Question for the fan base.
Ask it.
Can the Razor Crest not catch a break? From the beginning, it was my favorite ship. I thought it was the coolest ship I've ever seen in the Star Wars universe. Sue me if you don't like that opinion, but I thought it was. And then we get all the way to this episode, and at the end, when we see his ship all fixed up, I hurt more than Mando did, okay? I'm going to say it. I hurt more than Mando did. Oh, the poor Razor Crest.
It was. That part where it fell into the water, which, welcome to the Rantcast. We were on the planet of Kamino today because this episode was based on a water planet of Trask. Before we get into the Rantcast fully, make sure you drop a like, subscribe, check out the other videos, follow me on Instagram at DS Cosplay. Let's not pussyfoot around this stuff. Let's just get right into it.
Absolutely.
Get right into it. This episode of The Mandalorian, it was good.
Oh, absolutely. Well, I thoroughly enjoyed this episode. I want to start out like, I thoroughly enjoyed this episode because we got to see the expansion even further. The spectrum broaden of Star Wars. We get to see where certain creatures come from or species come from. And we got to just see like the repurposed AT-AT, right?
Yeah.
The repurposed, pulled the crest out of the water. We just got to see so much more Star Wars. We got to see our first actual boat in Star Wars or ship, boat ship.
Boat
in
ship, Star Wars. There was the one in episode 9 that Rey used, but it...
Yeah, it doesn't really count, but yeah,
it's like a kayak.
Come yeah, on. it was just cool to see more stuff from the Star Wars universe. Yeah. On top of course, the mind blowing things that happened in the episode.
So with this, I just want to say that we're gonna just cover two spoilers. Really, there's a couple spoilers, but we'll go over some of the other stuff in the video or that happened in the episode. But mainly, I've noticed that there are people out there who like to watch spoiler related stuff instead of watching the actual episode itself.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we're not going to cover every little tiny detail and, you know, do a review of every single second of the episode, just because, you know, there may be things we leave out that might be more fun to see
in person,
you know, in real time. So biggest thing for me, obviously, Bo-Katan coming back.
Huge.
And announcing that he's going to go find Ahsoka. My thing with Bo and Mando is I really like seeing the
differentiation between are you talking about
the children of the watch. And then I don't know if they're the night owls or the where Mando came from and where Bo came from. I really like that because seeing this, it was just something that kind of bothered me about the show. Dave Filoni taking the reins on this stuff, him and Jon Favreau, it was kind of weird to me because I'm like, well, he told this story in the Clone Wars, but he's telling this story. So now we finally see where this comes from.
Right, the differences.
Yeah, and we finally get to see, oh, hey, this is what it really is. And so, me, I'm Team Bo. Like, I love The Mandalorian, but I love where she comes from because I just... You know me, for as long as I've cosplayed, I've never shown my face.
Mm-hmm.
But I really, it just, I don't know, that just seems more, I don't know, I like that a lot more, that way of living a lot more with the Mandalorian stuff. I don't know how accurate it is to, you know, the original stuff, but apparently, the Mandalorian merch costuming club, they are, I guess, they have the same, I don't know, don't take this with a grain of salt, I don't know. But I've heard from people who have been involved in those costuming clubs that ever since The Mandalorian came out, they've enforced the rule of you can't take your helmet off during a troop.
Oh, wow.
Like, you can't show your face to the public.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of going to be weird and obviously Bo is canon. She's been canon since the Clone Wars. So I wonder how this is going to go. Is Mando going to go join her after dropping off the kid and, you know, renounce the ways of the Children of the Watch? Is he gonna say, screw you, Bo, I'm gonna help you, but I'm not taking off the helmet, I'm not living your ways?
Right. I'll help you, but I'm not going to devote myself to you.
And I understand the way of the Children of the Watch, because it's the old ways of the Mandalorian, and I guess the way of the Mandalore the Great, was the big guy.
Yeah, the head honcho.
In the Old Republic days. So I understand both sides, and it's really cool that we finally, those two worlds collide.
Mm-hmm.
It's really cool.
To see.
I think the guy's name was Axe Woves, the other Mandalorian. His chest plate was actually Mando's old one.
Oh,
like, really? It was shaped and looked like his old one.
Mm-hmm.
If you go back and watch it, it's really, really cool. He was pretty cool. And then Casa Reeves.
Mm-hmm.
Casca Reeves, Sasha Banks' character, wrestling fans here. Brady and I actually did wrestling. Brady and I, we both trained in professional wrestling. It was really, really cool that she showed up. Like, granted, I haven't been a huge Sasha Banks fan, but
still cool.
It's still cool, yeah. And the fact that, like, she's essentially her own stunt woman. Like, as wrestlers, you're your own stunt person. You're playing a character, and you're also having to do the stunts live in front of thousands of people. So it's really cool that, you know, almost everything that you saw her doing, she was probably doing herself.
Yeah, absolutely.
Which really, really, really cool.
Yeah.
A lot of people were saying that she's going to be Sabine Wren and this and that, and I'm glad she's her own person. Mm-hmm. I'm really, really glad she's her own person. Not the fact that I just didn't really like Rebels. I didn't hate Sabine. Sabine was really cool. I can't stand Ezra, but what's your take?
I just was, thinking about this. Oh, man, did I just have a brain fart? I think I did.
You did.
I just had a brain fart. That sucks.
Moving along. Find it, and then
we'll... yeah, I don't know if I'll find it.
You'll find it.
It's here, man.
Well, we'll move on to, the fact that I'm kind of completely glossing over. That Bo-Katan was played by Katie Sackhoff, who voiced Bo-Katan, which is really freaking cool.
It's a nice relief, actually, because so many times we see a certain character play someone in a show, and then they get replaced by somebody else in a different show.
Yeah.
Or a movie or something.
It's kind of like in Battlefront, where obviously Tamora Morrison reprises his role as Boba Fett. And, you know, Billy Dee Williams plays Lando. Daisy Ridley plays Rey. Excuse me, I gotta sneeze real quick. Excuse me. John Boyega reprises his role as Finn. And... what's her name? The lady who played Phasma.
Oh.
Gwendolyn Christie.
Yes. Gwendolyn Christie,
she reprises her role as Phasma, which I really like. I really like when characters who played them in live action play them in, you know, another version of the character. So it's really cool to see her play both characters.
Yeah, both in the animated and in this series.
Now we're going to get to the subject of Ahsoka. I'm going to try to keep this short and sweet. Who's the girl? Can you look up who's the girl who's going to be playing? I can't.
Oh, that's right.
Sor something. I know. I can't remember.
Yeah, if I can type, that'd be great.
Her. I know her face. Her name just always eludes me. Brady's looking that up. While Brady's looking that up.
Rosario Dawson.
She, I know her face. She may have been in some things I've seen. If you look up her IMDb, just put in Rosario Dawson IMDb and go to a list of her stuff. I'm not really familiar with her. A lot of people are saying she's an A-list celebrity. She's a queen of the crop that she's this big deal. Maybe she might be. I don't know. But in what I would like to see, and a lot of people, you know, may crucify me for this, is that I'd like to see Ashley Eckstein, the voice of Ahsoka, reprise, you know, play a live-action Ahsoka, especially since she voiced her in Rise of Skywalker, but whatever. I'd really like to see that, because, it's really cool, but from what my understanding is, I guess people are saying she doesn't need to play Ahsoka because she's making enough money, and she's this, and she's that, and, you know, she Rosario Dawson deserves her shine. I wouldn't be mad with either. I wouldn't. You're making a puzzle face. What are you saying?
Apparently, she was in Justice League Dark Apocalypse War as the voice for Wonder Woman. That's the animated one, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
What else was she?
Let's see. Zombieland Double Tap. She was in the second Zombieland.
We saw that.
Yes, we did. I think that's the girl that, what's his name, goes and see? Tallahassee. He falls in love with. at the place, and then her second boyfriend shows up, and they,
Okay. Okay. So she was a side character in that one.
Mm-hmm. Yes. I know she's in some other movies.
I know she, I saw, I looked
Henchman. Up. She's in Henchman. As a voice, it says, but.
Have I seen Henchman?
Yeah, it's a weird superhero one. I wasn't a super big fan of it.
Oh.
I'm looking. Iron Fist, the TV show. Oh, I think she's in another TV show. I'm just trying to think.
But anyway, yeah, we'll come back to that. I wouldn't be mad. I just think it'd be really cool for Ashley Eckstein to actually play Ahsoka. Just know how much she has love for the character. She's been playing Ahsoka for 10-plus years.
Mm-hmm.
She's voiced her in so many things. And if you look up, you know, Ashley Eckstein's IMDb, she played her. So she did so many voices in Clone Wars.
Mm.
And she was also Ahsoka in Rebels. And again, she voiced Ahsoka in Rise of Skywalker. But I just think it'd be cool that she's been doing all this work. It'd be cool to finally put her in the makeup. In the prosthetics, you
Absolutely.
Play Ahsoka. I know Ahsoka around this time is probably about 40 years old. So that's not terribly old.
No.
That's not terribly old. Plus, we don't know how fast her species ages. But, you know, either or, I think it'd be really, really cool if either, you know, just seeing a live-action Ahsoka in general would be really cool. As a child of the Clone Wars,
mm-hmm.
growing up with the Clone Wars, even the 2000... If you did not see the 2003 animated short series that we got for Clone Wars, you don't understand the struggle of Clone Wars. But, yeah, it'll be really cool to see Ahsoka. I'm really wondering how they'll handle it. Is Mando going to drop off the child and that's it for the child's arc? Because... with that, Moff Gideon, which I really... when he popped up on the hologram, I was like, yo, he's back. The big baddie.
Finally.
He's finally, you know...
four or five episodes?
Because
I don't think he was in the very last episode.
Yeah, he was.
Oh, he was? Okay.
Yeah, he tried killing him with the TIE Fighter.
Oh, that's right. That was the end
of
the...
How do you forget about that?
That was... Well, I remembered that, but I thought there was an episode after that. But you're right, there wasn't. So it's been three episodes.
It's been three episodes, or two episodes, technically, since we've seen him. And the Imperial officer... who was straight up Nazi.
Yeah.
Like, we all know that Star Wars was based around World War II.
Mm-hmm.
Based around, you know,
with the uniforms and stuff.
Yeah, stuff like that. So, he's straight up, like, he's Jimmy O from Sons of Anarchy. Sons of Anarchy.
And that makes two characters.
Yeah, because in season one, there's Bobby.
Mm-hmm.
And this one, there's Jimmy O. Which, at first, when I was watching, I was like, if this guy had an Irish accent, I knew where he'd be from. if he had an Irish accent, I knew where he'd be from. And I was bugging Brady. I was like, Brady needs to see this episode.
It's true.
Because I had seen Sons of Anarchy prior. Like, I think I only saw like one or two episodes. And then Brady put me back on it when he got into it. And so I was like, oh, Jimmy O, that's really cool. And then before we get more into the child stuff, are we not going to talk about the Kraken?
Okay, first of all, that was unnecessary. I don't like the ocean. I don't like the creatures in the ocean. Actually, I take that back. The ocean's a very beautiful thing, but the creatures in it are all designed to kill you, and I hate it. So to go, and it doesn't matter if it is in Star Wars or what movie it's in, when we go, and just like in Pirates of the Caribbean, and I see this Kraken mouth come from underneath the water of the ship, and then Mando gets thrown in there. I wanted to throw up along with baby kicked in its mouth. It's disgusting.
Oh,
it was terrifying. I hated that. Hated that so much. And that actually brings me to my point I went brain farted on. Everyone is suddenly, in season two, after his Beskar more than they're after Baby Yoda. So it makes me wonder what happened to the whole Baby Yoda hunted thing. Like, Mando says, the only way I keep alive is by keeping moving. There's bounty hunters on every planet, and as, it was said in the episode, every single person, every bounty hunter got a tracker to track down Baby Yoda.
Mm-hmm.
So how come we haven't seen any more bounty hunters since then? Since this new season, first episode, everyone's been after solely his Beskar. Which kind of just is like, it's weird to me. I'm not saying it's bad, it's just weird to me that suddenly
they want the Beskar more than the child.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe, you know, they're after him and the Beskar and the child, but... I don't know. That's a good question. That's a good question. I don't know the answer to that one.
I just thought that was interesting. But yes, the Kraken.
Because every person that he's come across is like, you know, we will give us that Beskar. Give us the Beskar. And then the last little thing before we go off to the Ahsoka thing again is the Mon Calamari fixing a ship.
That hurts me so much. I just want to see the ship restored back to its former glory, and it gets worse every time.
It was really weird, or not really weird, but it was funny the fact that, you know, when he first drops the ship off, he's like, do what you can for it, whatever. He's like, I can put fuel in it if it'll hold fuel. And then after he's like, that's the best you did after it's like, God, bunch of, what did you say it was? The wire.
No, the fish netting and the rope. And it looked like a bunch of, like those blue dumpsters you see all over got caught up and, like, just slapped onto it. I was like, how is this going to hold up in space?
Well, and after he's like, I gave you 1,000 credits and this is the best you could do. The dude just hands him the pad, like, sign, sonny boy. Like, yeah. He's just like, sign for it. This is what you get. Hopefully the crest holds up.
I hope we see... I don't know. I almost have a feeling that we're going to see him get a new ship. Like a really nice ship.
I don't know, though, because they've already started selling Razor Crest toys.
Ooh.
So I don't think they're going to... I think it'll kind of be like the Ghost. Or it'll be the new Falcon.
Mm.
That things keep popping up with it and you know, keep happening to it. But I wouldn't imagine seeing them get rid of the crest. I think the Slave One might make a return, which is one of my favorite ships in Star Wars. I love the Slave One. It's sick. Every time we play Battlefront, like if we're all just hanging out or whatever and I'm playing Battlefront, and I'll just go onto Bespin and play as Boba and jump onto the Slave One and just be on it because it's so freaking sick. But anyway, the Ahsoka stuff to close, how do you think, what is your kind of like your feelings towards, will they drop the child off with Ahsoka, then he goes and does his thing? Will he go to drop the child off to Ahsoka and won't be able to do it?
Personal preference, I hope they do. I hope he drops off the child to Ahsoka. Ahsoka agrees to take care of it. Whether this is just a cameo or where we see her in future episodes where Mando does come back and just check on the child. Not take him anywhere, just check in. Just come in and check in. I think that'd be okay. But at the same time, I would like to see the Mandalorian move away from the Baby Yoda thing. Because I feel like I'm scared that that Baby Yoda is going to take the credibility away once Baby Yoda's gone. And I really like the Mando. I would love to see the Mandalorian go help Bo-Katan retake Mandalore. That could be a whole season or two seasons, season and a half of helping her take that back. And we've got the story arc. Basically, they're connected with Moff Gideon and all that stuff. So I don't know. I would like to see the Baby Yoda arc end and a new arc continue.
Yeah, it definitely, because there's still so much that, like, I look at the, I've rewatched the season 2 trailer a couple times, and I'm just kind of like, huh, like, there's still so much we haven't seen.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently there's going to be 13 episodes in total with this, so 13 episodes from the first episode in season 2.
And we're only at 3, so that leaves 10 to go.
Yeah, which is like, shit.
That's a lot, yeah.
And so, if there is 10 more episodes. Anyway, it's just kind of the big question, I guess, is will the Mandalorian, the show, lose credibility without Baby Yoda? Like, I feel like we've seen so much. I think they're slowly weaning us off of the child just because he spent almost an entire episode, this past episode, without the kid.
Mm-hmm.
And it didn't feel any different. It didn't feel worse. It didn't feel better. It felt like it was something. It felt like it was kind of
a refreshment. It was refreshing to see.
And so with how much money they are making off of Baby Yoda from this stuff, it's kind of like, I don't know. They can't kill off the kid.
No.
My thing is, what I don't want them to do is have them be like, oh, I can't give up this child. This child's my son. Go give him to Ahsoka, but from time to time, just keep going and visiting the child, making Ahsoka freaking Tano
a
glorified babysitter. I don't want that. I want them to either stick with it or gracefully end the plot. But, again, we're still in this season of what's going to happen, so... Yeah, I guess that's the big question. Do you think that the Mandalorian will lose credibility without Baby Yoda? Do you think people will stop watching? Certain people will stop watching because there's no Baby Yoda anymore. But that'll do it for this rantcast. Sorry, this one's coming up so late, but there definitely will be another one next week. And yeah, we'll see.
And we'll have to make sure we do that one as early as possible because I leave for Arizona for a week.
Thanksgiving's coming up. So we might do one. I don't know. We may do two in one. So maybe not next week, but you know, after the holiday and stuff like that. So yeah, that'll do it. Thanks for checking out this rant cast, and
we'll see you guys on the next one.
See you guys in the next one. This is the way.
This is the way.